Welcome to Draw and Design. In this video, we will install rebars in a concrete stairs. So this will be a step-by-step tutorial. So watch the full video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So without any further delay, let's start the video. We have a concrete stair with a small foundation on its bottom and a slab attached to its top. Section 1 is showing the longer run side and section 2 is showing the smaller run side. Go to section 1 and click on rebar in structure tab. Set the position to parallel to current work plane and then select the shape number 1. Now click inside the foundation of stairs. Let's change the dia of rebar to number 5. Let's write stair foundation in partition and main rebar in schedule mark. Again, click on rebar, select the shape number 0, select near cover reference with parallel to work plane and change the dia, write stair foundation in partition and distribution bar in schedule mark. Let's click inside the foundation. Let's change layout to maximum spacing. Now use the rotate tool to rotate the position of the rebar. Grab the rebar and move to the correct position using the grip arrow. Let's start again with rebar, but this time we will select the sketch rebar. Now we will select the structure in which we will install the rebar. We will select the concrete stair, and for the offset for the cover we will select pick line tool with an offset of 1/2 inch, and we will select the lines from where our rebar will pass. Remember, this rebar will pass as a crossing rebar. It means for the starting it will be the outer rebar, but at the stair run portion it will be the under rebar. Using the trim tool we will connect the lines, and for the end hook and starting hook we will make a line 1 foot. We can drag the line using the mouse, and for the end hook cover will be also provided. Now click on finish edit mode and our rebar is in place. Now we will change the dia for rebar to number 4. So this will be the final rebar. Now again start with rebar, and this time again with sketch rebar, and for the stairs we will select pick line tool, and for the stair top main bars we will install the top main bars using line tool and pick line tool and drawing like this from this point to other point. This will be installed considering the cover. The top rebar will be added up to L/3, and using the trim extend tools and offset tools we will manage the position of the rebar. Like this. And for the bottom we will also install a hook 1 foot long. Using the pick line tool like this and trim extend tool, now select the line and change the dimension to 1 foot. Now grab the rebar and drag a little bit up and click on finish edit mode. To manage the position of rebar, we can use the grip tools provided in middle section of each rebar, and we can adjust the positions, and also we can adjust the dias like this. Now again go to rebar and sketch tool. Now as you can see, now I am installing a rebar from the bottom side, and it will go crossing the other rebar and at the distance of L by 3, in where L is the total length of run, this rebar will go up to L by 3 and crossing the other rebar like this, which means this rebar is bottom rebar on the starting point, but the top rebar on the ending point. This is called the crossing method. Now that the main reinforcement and first run is complete, we will go to section 2. Now we will repeat the same processes in the second run also. We will select the rebars, sketch tools, select the stairs, and we will using the drawing tool with an offset of cover, and we will start the drawing of main reinforcements. In here we will also consider the crossing method of rebar. As you can see, the rebar starting from bottom but ending on top, and then again in the slab area it will be installed on the bottom side like this. Now using trim extend tools and other drawing tools, by grabbing this rebar you will complete and then click on finish edit mode. Now click on finish edit mode. We can grab the rebar and change the positions, adjusting the covers and positions. Now again go to rebar sketch tool and select the stair using the pick line tool, and again draw the other rebar. Now this rebar will start from the top, go to bottom side of run, and then again go to top side of slab. The process is same. We will install a hook on the end and then using trim extend tool and then click on finish edit mode. Now that we have installed the main reinforcement, we have some weak portions in our stairs. So as you can see, we have weak portions in all the reinforcement. So we will again go to rebar, and now this time we will install some extra reinforcement on top side in this area. This reinforcement will be considered as extra reinforcement. The process is same. We will use the drawing tool, trim extend tools, and other small tools, and we will quickly finish this extra reinforcement also in the foundation and stair join area. We will install some additional reinforcement. Now in the section 2 we will also install some additional reinforcements where the landing meets the second run and the landing meets with the slab. All areas are weak, so we will install additional reinforcements. Our additional reinforcement is complete. Now we will view all of our rebars in 3D view. Now select all the drawing, then click on filter, uncheck all the items, click on structural rebar, apply, and OK. Now in the properties panel, click on view visibility state, check mark the 3D view in solid and unobscured. This will select the rebars. Now select layout, maximum spacing, and give the spacing between rebars. And as you can see, our rebars are showing completely fine. Also for the footing, this rebar is not complete, so we'll select maximum spacing with some spacing distance, and in the 3D view you can see our complete rebar sets are ready. Before we move further, please subscribe to my channel and like this video. This will help me a lot. Now it's time to install the distribution bars. I am using shape number 0 and placing it in parallel to current work plane. Now I have installed 2 rebars. I am using the maximum spacing, then using a grip tool to drag the rebars on the correct position like this. We can adjust the position anytime using these blue grip arrows like this. Now the foundation rebars are installed, and for the stairs I will use the same procedure using maximum spacing. This time I will move and rotate the rebar. And rotate like this so it will align with the main rebars, and using these grip arrows I will drag up to the top like this. Now again for the top reinforcement I will use copy tool. Copy the bottom reinforcement on the top and then using these grip arrows to adjust the position like this. Please remember that the design of reinforcement in different rebars, different stairs is different. It depends on the project strength and the location of stairs. Now go to section 2 and do the same for the distribution bars in this section. Place the rebar, select maximum spacing, give the spacing, then rotate. Then using the rotate tool and grab the rebars on the correct position. Using the grip tool, place on the correct position, and then copy tool on the top side like this, and then grab the rebars from the grip and place on the perfect area. In the 3D view you cannot see the rebars which we installed just now, so select all the drawing and using the filter tool select the desired rebar. Go to view visibility state and check mark the. Now you can see all the reinforcements are in place and this looks just fine. Now we will select the rebars and quickly name them. Name the partition and schedule marks. We will one by one select all the rebars and then change the names of partition and give the schedule marks. These schedule marks and partition names depends on your drawing and your project style. Feel free to change. Now that all the rebars are in place, we will go to view, click on schedules and click on schedules or quantities. Now in this table we will find structural rebar and then click OK. Now we will add all the components which are required to be added in our schedule. First we will add partitions, schedule mark, we will add bar diameter, We will add spacing, bar length, parts of bar, then we will add quantities of rebar, then total length of rebar, and then click OK. Our schedule is ready. Now again go to fields, and we need to add a new parameter, which is the unit mass of rebar, set as type, discipline as structural, and the parameter type as unit mass. Now add a formulated parameter named as total mass, discipline as structural, type as mass. And for the formula, we will select total bar length and multiplication sign, and then select unit mass and click OK. Now our unit mass and total mass is ready. We will adjust the table. Again go to field setting. Now we will add shape of rebar, and we will add comments, and then click OK. Our whole table is ready. Now this schedule, for the unit mass, we will adjust the units, 2 decimal points, and remove the zero trailing. And for the total mass, also unit setting as kilograms, 2 decimal points, and remove the zero trailing. We will add the unit masses, and for the same rebar dia, Revit will automatically enter all the unit weights like this. So we have the total weight. Again go to sorting and grouping, click on grand total. Now go to total mass, calculate totals. So we have totals. I am going too fast. The reason is that I have described all the procedure of rebar schedule in my other video. You can see the video in the link in the description. We will adjust units of all the parts of rebar, and bar length, total length, and everything. We will go to decimal feet system. Like this. Now after adjusting the rebar schedule, as you can see, our rebar schedule is complete. We will adjust the position, center lines, alignment, everything. We will open up new sheets. All of this procedure is defined in my previous video. I am pasting the link in this description. We will drag the rebar schedule into our sheet. We will adjust this rebar schedule a little bit, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you really enjoyed this video, feel free to subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.